Coming to Ashish, being in an EPC company, technology is one aspect of it, but in the current context today, you see a lot of challenges actually as an EPC company. Which are the major ones probably that you would like to highlight?
You can say that the industry is in a flux. There are a lot of changes which are happening. Suddenly the spate of tenders that are coming out has reduced a bit, or probably the sizes have increased a bit. So the kind of developers has changed. So probably earlier there were a lot of mid-sized developers, and now the industry is like consolidating or becoming focused towards some large developers, which in turn has led to various other kind of developments. But I would still say that on the EPC side, the challenges remain pretty much the same. In case we have several projects where the land acquisition is with us, and some of them it is not with us. I would take it as a whole, and I would also address issues that come in terms of whatever issues are there for the EPC. So land acquisition, is, you can say, is one of the biggest challenges that is there, and we have faced that in some of our projects. Then on the rooftop side, there is a lot of clarity that is still to come in terms of there are a lot of demands that we, if you see worldwide, the industry has been a rooftop driven industry, while in India it is predominantly utility is far far bigger than the rooftop. Mainly because there is a small thing that probably you can do, that increase the size of the maximum power plant from say 1 megawatt for net metering, or we can do things like small, these are very small things which can be done immediately, or increase, allow net metering higher than the consumption. So a lot of go downs that there, which are lying free, and the developers are there, or the owners of those premises are willing to kind of, so that helps the EPC players, or the market becomes bigger for everybody, for the developer, EPC, everybody. I'm not talking purely from an EPC perspective. It also helps other players also in getting the industry increase per se. And as we are on the rooftop side, probably there are lot of more that needs to be done on the rooftop side, because India has lagged behind in the rooftop space. While utility scale, a lot of work has happened. If you see our portfolio per se, we have done 10 megawatt on rooftop, and around by December we should be around 140 megawatt on the utility scale. So the from our perspective, we are probably happy that in case we are not getting work here, we are getting work there. But from an from national perspective, from the EPC perspective, if the rooftop industry is increase, the amount of work which can come will be phenomenal. That is our point.
Thanks, Ashish. I think so, Kartik, you have also been primarily focusing on rooftop. Where do you see, what are the steps really? Today, everybody is talking about the rooftop, but everybody is trying to jump into the rooftop per se. But rooftop as a market itself has its own set of challenges, because it is not still evolved. I was reading some report yesterday, still we say 810 megawatt is only the installed capacity in India as far as rooftop is concerned, while we are talking about 12 gigawatt under the utility side. So it's still very, very nascent market as far as rooftop is concerned, but today focus for everybody is getting into the rooftop. What do you see the steps which are missing actually to see the rooftop market gets developed into a strong, robust market? Worldwide, I think so, rooftop has been the major quotient as far as the development on any of the markets is concerned. Maybe you can add some points to how we can really develop onto the rooftop side.
I mean, I really wish I really knew the answer to that of how we can actually, but yes, I have a few thoughts on this. First of all, on the worldwide rooftop market, right? I think the primary reason worldwide that the rooftop market is actually bigger than the utility scale market is actually quite economical, right? Because in India, we have the cheapest electricity for residentials, whereas over there, it's the opposite, right? Over there, the house owner actually pays a huge amount of money for per unit electricity that they consume. And actually, industries and commercials actually come out quite cheap. So that's why the adoption in the US or in the West really happened on the residential scale, which is a much faster deployment if you think about it, because again, there are very highly credible people over there, right? All their credits and all are very, so even on the residential side, most of the companies doing that business over there are RESCOs. There are hardly any EPCs who are actually doing business in with the end customer in US. So I think that's a problem which I don't know how ever India can, you know, battle with, because of our cross subsidy approach and highly regulated electricity market. But at the same time, wherever we are, I think strengthening our current, I mean, Indian solar market actually has a very dubious advantage also, which is because the industrial is the first segment to be adopting solar. The speed at which our rooftop solar has picked up in the first couple of years, 3 years, I really don't consider the industrial rooftop market more than 3 years old. I think it is a 3 year old market. So coming to an 800 megawatt in rooftop solar in 3 years is actually much faster than UK's first gigawatt or Spain's first gigawatt or US's first gigawatt, because they were developing small projects. Now, while they were, again, you know, these companies which were developing these small projects were grew really slowly. For example, a company like Oriano has come from a 0 to 150 megawatts. That's anywhere a turn. That's a half a million dollar turnover, right? In the next 2 years or something like that. Half a billion rupees turnover, right? 500 CR, 600 CR in 3 years. So no company in the US would have been able to do that quickly. So we need to kind of turn this around in our favor, which I think on the industrial side, the places where we really fall, I think, is, you know, delivering. So I think the biggest challenge, if every time I come around it, I come to the same point, I think, is talent. Okay. The reason why because of this queue in solar, right, 12 gigawatts of ground mounted and one less than 1 gigawatt of rooftop, the major talent, technical, commercial, and all of that is all sitting in the ground mounted scheme of things. We, you know, even scaling from a 5 member to a 40 member team now, I know the kind of challenges that we've gone through in getting the right kind of talent. So I think if we, you know, step up our game as a country in producing talent for the rooftop solar industry in a more sustainable way, and, you know, kind of impart those best practices at that level, at the grassroots level, then I think that's a much more sustainable way of pushing our rooftop solar segment forward, right? Because on a 200 kilowatt project, if you deliver poor quality, right, it hurts you tremendously, right? And going forward, we'll be doing small projects. So we really need to do the small things right in order to become a trustworthy, because it's a problem of trust ultimately. Once the industry start trusting us, right, they'll go out and give a lot more business. OPEX, CAPEX doesn't matter, right? Everybody, as long as they put up solar. So there, I think, that the talent problem is at the core of the rooftop solar's growth. And of course, financing, let us not go there. You know, that's, again, you know, any financier that you meet today, right, they're always talking about, even the developers, even the rooftop developers who are trying to do it, are all thinking about that, you know, how do we reach our first gigawatt in rooftop solar? How will we do that? Because reaching maybe the first 10 megawatt or 50 or 100 or 150 or 200 megawatt is okay, right? It's maybe 100, 200 plants. But when it comes to a gigawatt, it means that you'll be doing maybe 50 plants, 60 plants, 70 plants a quarter, right? And then ramping that up to a 200 plants a quarter. So do our EPC companies today really have the kind of processes or the kind of technology enablement to push that kind of work out? I think the answer is no, right? So I think there are two fronts. Number one is talent. We make talent better. And number two is we really focus on technology which helps us scale.
I'll just add a few points. There was one more point that he touched upon. Was the credit worthiness of the plants. The credit ratings of individuals is pretty strong, and the risk of default for a customer is pretty high over in the West, which is not the case. People will default even on an auto loan, and it will be very difficult for you to recover. So if you're putting something on their roof and they move away, it is very, very difficult. So that is why finance has probably not moved into rooftop. I don't know whether you were there in the morning session. All the financials were very, very clear in terms of, like, they were, I would say, blunt in the face. We are not doing kind of rooftop solar. You can talk to our retail side of our business. We won't be able to touch it. That was the kind of message. And that has been their stand. Being a banker, I know, ex-banker, so I know what from what background they are coming from. And So in case we are able to do something on the credit rating side, there are a lot of finance will move in. A lot of developers who are active in the space are already working on that side. And if you see, not only West, even in countries like Bangladesh, it is 80% rooftop. It's not only a work in terms of, talent and all. If Bangladesh is very pretty similar to what India is.
Thanks, Ashish. I think so. So very, very good sharing of information from Kartik, Ashish and Ritesh. If anybody else wants to deliberate on any of the points from the panelists, we'll do, or else maybe we can throw open the session for the questions if somebody from the audience said.
So any questions, or everybody understood everything? Yeah. Yeah, good.
Hi, my name is Manmohan. Do we have applications of trackers in rooftop also?
Currently, we don't design for the rooftop market because there's a lot of design considerations, specifically the weight and all of that. So we're not covering the rooftop market as of yet.
I think there's a huge possibility into that because everybody's talking about rooftop and the people like you who are working on technology would not take care of that. So
see, the problem is that you would need a significant, when we do a product, it's not that we just take a product and just design it. We go through a complete set, is almost a year of testing, evaluation, international testing, I mean in wind tunnel tests and all of that. So when you're doing every roof, now they're all different types of roofs in India. Again, weight, I mean, it's not like you could just carry the you can actually take the ground mounted, now the independent, we have both block and row technology. You can take the row, but the row is 63 meters long. How many roofs will you have 63 meters or 40 meters long? So there's a lot of changes that need to be made, and if those changes are made, the cost will escalate. So that 10% increment might become 20%, 30%, 40%. Okay, so that is where, I mean, and it's on a case to case basis. Unless it's like a 3, 4, 5 megawatt project, then we would look at it. But below that, the cost would be prohibitive.
Okay. Thanks.
I think using trackers on rooftops, probably on the ground can take more weight or load at certain points. And if on the roof, we'll have more load on certain points, it might just cause a lot of damage to the roof. So probably devising a tracker which equally distributes the weight of the entire system over the roof,
you will see,
would increase the cost and
right.
Yeah,
but you
so
will see some people developing trackers for roof, but ask them whether they've actually done a boundary layer wind tunnel test and you'll find out they haven't. So the next time, I mean, if you even if you go to even the fixed tilt structures that you're developing and deploying on your roof, you ask them what validation that they've done, and they'll not be able to give you any validation. They'll say this consultant and that consultant, but every consultant does what he's paid for.
I think so. To add to what Ritesh and Anand said correctly, I think so in India, majority of the roofs, they don't have real structural stability. In fact, qualifying for the normal system, which is getting installed onto the roof, many of the places you find it difficult to really validate the structural stability, especially in the PEB structures actually, because they have been designed for the very, very minimum standards. Nobody has planned in advance that we wanted to install a solar in future. So the load bearing capacity in terms of dead load as well as live load is a major challenge for majority of the industrial and commercial rooftops. Adding to that, if you want to add another weight from the trackers, it will be further more difficult actually, and scale and volumes will be the only solution for you to optimize the cost if you really want to do it. So still, I think so that's a challenge as far as developing trackers on the rooftop projects are concerned.
So we have any more questions? Just a brief about technology. Definitely technology is evolving very fast and becoming more and more robust, and that is why we have all these numbers and magic of grid parity or below grid parity prices. And I'm sure we'll see a lot of disruption in the technology space with respect to panels moving to 1500 volts, PERC, monoPERC, heterojunction or bifacial or IBC cells. Inverters definitely are evolving a lot of energy storage is on the card. So, and we keep on hearing that in labs, the efficiency level of cells and modules are constantly rising. Even the product warranty rise is also very well anticipated. So definitely, we look forward for a great innovation in technology space that will further make the case for going solar more and more attractive, more and more viable. So thank you very much. Very engaging, very involving discussions from this panel. I would request a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for them. I'll further take this opportunity to request our session chair, Amit Barveji, to present small gifts to our session speakers.